you must still be so proud of everything you achieved in Rush.
You know, it's been one of these really surprising journeys, and I think that's what people like about the movie, is they see it and they're surprised too. Creatively it was challenging, physically it was challenging, there's a little element of actual danger involved in making the movie. People have embraced it in a way that I'm not sure we necessarily all expected they would. So it's been thrilling.
How many U.S. fans do you think you converted to Formula One fans?
I don't know that a movie could actually convert somebody, but I think we've opened a few minds to a sport that I've really come to really have a lot of respect for.
I mean, it is one of those films that can go on and on because of the fact that the sport will go on and on, and it's a fascinating, look at it.
Well, movies do that. They find their audience and they play in a way that they, more now than ever. And so that's gratifying. And yes, when you make a movie about a particular subject, I've discovered from making a movie about space, which was Apollo 13, or firefighters, which was Backdraft, there's something particular about it that differentiates it, over a long period of time. So I'm hoping the same thing happens with this.
One thing I'd say about your films is that it doesn't matter whether you watch them on the cinema or on an iPad or on a DVD, because they're all great films.
Okay.
Some films, and not taking away from Gravity, we were just discussing, could you watch that, on an iPad? Or
it's an awfully good story. It's best seen on a big screen. And frankly, I think Rush is a movie best seen on a big screen because it is a kind of an experiential cinematic presentation, it's always comes down to story, and if the stories are rich or tense and interesting and the characters are emotional or funny or whatever it is they're supposed to be, then it makes for good watching.
We've got the new Formula One season starting next month. A lot of rule changes. People say the excitement's being taken away, smaller engines, everything. Do you think you can make as exciting a film about Formula One in 2014?
It's always the characters, and it's still a competition, so there's drama in that, and we don't know. We don't know whose story would warrant, a movie. No telling, but sure there are going to be stories. And by the way, Loud is very excited about this year. He thinks it's going to be a really fascinating year because of those changes.
Now, you're no stranger to award season. How do you pace yourself at this time of year?
Well, partly by not getting as emotionally involved and being more collegial about it. Like we were hearing them cheer, Leo, Leo, Leo. Well, I get a chance to track Leo down. I haven't seen him in a little while. And he did J. Edgar for Imagine a couple of years ago. And we know each other. And so for me, I work very hard. I also focus a lot on family. Honestly, when I have a movie that's in the award season, it's an excuse, a reason to go out and see a lot of people who I know and like, or meet people who I didn't know before. Like, this circuit, I've been able to meet and get to know Alfonso Cuarón. Very cool guy. Never knew him. Always liked his movies. We've had some fun conversations because of this.
Cool.
And where are we with Arrested Development? Just last question. Any new stuff on the horizon?
Well, a definite, desire. It was a mystery. Only Mitch Hurwitz, the creator, knows where the mystery's going exactly. Although I have a clue, and it's pretty interesting, I think we want to finish the mystery somehow, however he does it.
Okay, great. Thanks very much.